Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector.
DRDO is silently working on a couple of directed energy weapon projects which we are going to discuss in great details. We have seen very little news regarding the same, citing the confidentiality of the project. What we will be discussing will be based on the information available in the public domain. Israel is the first country in this world to shoot down a flying drone from a plane armed with directed energy weapon and has demonstrated that capability recently. DRDO has also tested some of the key technologies required to fire high energy focused beam, which we also call as a direct energy weapon. Presently, DRDO has only tested it on small scale. However, the work is in progress to develop 10 kilowatt and 20 kilowatt direct energy weapons. A directed energy weapon is designed to burn its target with highly focused energy, including laser, microwaves, and particle beams. According to the US think tank Lexington Institute, directed energy weapons have several advantages over conventional munitions. First, they transmit lethal force at the speed of light, about 3 lakh kilometers per second. Second, the beams are not affected by constraining effects of gravity or atmospheric drag. Third, they are extremely precise. Fourth, the effects can be tailored by varying the type and intensity of energy delivered against the targets. The directed energy weapon and radio frequency jammers are going to rule the next generation weapons for defending against UAVs, cruise, and ballistic missiles. The DUs rely on spark gap based method. Those who have done electrical or electronics engineering can relate to spark gap systems. Under this method, two conducting electrodes are separated by a gap, usually filled with a gas such as air, designed to allow an electric spark to travel between the conductors. Radio frequency weapons work on electronic components of missiles and radars, basically any device emitting or operating under radio frequency. As per the latest report, DRDO is working on the development of 10 kilowatt proof of concept directed energy system to protect against small targets like UAVs. It is working on technologies of precision tracking, pointing, and use of laser beams to neutralize the UAVs. Between January 2018 and March 2019, DRDO has silently conducted tests for detection and tracking of mini drone hexacopter with battlefield surveillance radar and queuing to 10 kilowatt DES. Testing of radar interfacing with 10 kilowatt DES was carried out with 10 kilowatt DES radar interface simulator and air defense fire control radar Atulya at BEL Bengaluru. The target acquisition, tracking, and laser pointing of 10 kilowatt anti-UAV laser weapon system was carried out on flying drones at DRDO's Hyderabad-based lab up to a range of 0.7 kilometers. DRDO has also taken up a project to develop high-power microwave system of radio frequency whose power lies in S-band of electromagnetic spectrum. The HPM will be able to neutralize and fry the electronics of the drones from a distance of 5 kilometers. During June 2018 trial, the indigenous MARX generator was tested up to 300 kilovolt, 20 gigahertz frequency, and excellent performance was obtained. These generators are used to generate high power microwaves. The military application for the compact HPM system is extensive, given the potential threats posed by missiles. This system can also be integrated with land-based mobile vehicles and larger transport aircrafts. DRDO has sought for $100 million from Ministry of Defense from 2021 to 2022 budget to produce a high-power laser weapon. The classified project, dubbed Durga 2, directionally unrestricted ray gun array, aimed to develop 100 kilowatt lightweight directed energy system. At present, Durga 2 is in the concept stage. DRDO is developing and improving various laser generation techniques using solid state, fiber, and chemical lasers for defensive and offensive use. Durga 2 is to be integrated with land, sea, and air-based platforms. Around 50 defense scientists have been working and developing new directed energy weapons. DRDO is also aiming to start work on non-nuclear electromagnetic pulse technology. The Laser Science and Technology Center is the lead laboratory in this effort, and it is currently engaged in the development of multiple laser technologies using chemical oxygen iodine lasers and high-power fiber lasers. The center has so far made a 25 kilowatt laser that can target a ballistic missile during its terminal phase at a maximum distance of 5 kilometers.
This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.